गुड आफ्टरनून माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस पार्वती, पीजीटी फिजिक्स, होली हार्ट्स एजुकेशनल एकेडमी, रायपुर, छत्तीसगढ़। आई एम हियर विद अनदर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एम्पियर सर्क्यूट लॉ, दैट इज टोरॉइड। व्हाट इज ए टोरॉइड? मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू ए टोरॉइड। व्हाट इज टोरॉइड? ए टोरॉइड इज नथिंग बट वेरी सिंपल, टेक ए स्प्रिंग एंड मोल्ड इट और होल्ड इट लाइक दैट, इट विल फॉर्म ए सर्कल। टेक ए स्प्रिंग एंड देन जस्ट फॉर्म इट एज ए ring, a ring, spring in the form of ring here. Toroid is nothing but it is an endless solenoid. It is called endless solenoid. Take a solenoid, you know solenoid, just now we have studied, and you fold it like this here. In the form of ring, you take that act as a toroid. So, a toroid is nothing but a hollow circular ring on which a large number of insulated copper wire, copper turnings are of a metallic wire are closely wound. A toroid is nothing but a hollow circular ring on which a large number of insulated turns of a metallic wire are closely wound. Suppose I have taken a ring like this. Okay, this is the ring, and I have taken an insulated copper wire and I am taking the windings like this. Okay, that is called toroid. A toroid is nothing but endless solenoid. Take a solenoid and bend it like this, form a circle. That is nothing but toroid. A toroid is nothing but endless solenoid. Got it? Okay. So, let us find the expression for magnetic field due to a toroid. How many regions you can imagine in the toroid? Three. What are they? Number one, if this is a toroid, of course you imagine there are windings. There are windings here. There are windings here like this. So, how many regions are there? Number one, inside. Number three, outside. And inside. Between the hollow. It is a hollow. Total hollow. Okay. So, there are three ring if you take. How many are there? You tell me. Suppose if this is a ring. How many regions? Inside. Number one. Number two is here. Inside this, what you can, of course, windings are there, circular like this. Second, third is outside here. So, there are three circles you can take. Each is having radius R1, R2, R3. So, let us find out the expression for magnetic field intensity due to a toroid, that is endless solenoid. Okay. So, if I is a current flowing through the solenoid, each turn of the solenoid here, each there, and here through the toroid, let the amount of current passing through it is I. Okay, each turn, jo lapeta hua, each turn mein I current. Aisa kitne turns hai? N turns. So, what is the total turn? Bataye, that is N into, total current is N into I. Total number of turns into current carrying by each turn is I. So, N into I gives you the total current flowing through the toroid. Okay. So, let us apply the Ampere circuital law here to find out the magnetic field due to a toroid. Okay. So, now you have some idea about the toroid. I would like to show the diagram. How the toroid will look like that. It is like that, a cylindrical, yeah, toroid. How many regions? See, the red lines are what here? Ring. On the ring, the black lines are insulated copper wire wound on this toroid here. On this toroid. How many regions here? The region 1 is. So, let us move. This is the toroid. Now, let us. How many regions are there? Inside. Violet color. See. Dotted line. One region 1. R1 having the radius. And second region, you know that R2. And third region, R3 here. 1, 2, 3. There are 3, sir. Amperian loops we are taking. Right? So, according to Ampere's circuital law, if you observe carefully, for loop 1, integral B1 dot dl is equal to mu naught I into B1 dot dl. B1 dot dl, mu naught I. That is first one. Second one is B3 outside you take here. B3 dot dl is mu naught I. It is all zero. This is also zero. Why? Because inside no current is flowing here. So I is zero here. That is why this is zero. And in outside also, third region, also current is zero. So this is zero here. In second region, because of the effect of the current flowing through the second region, okay, so what is the value? Loop 2, if you take B2 dot dl is equal to mu naught I into, on this one, how many turns are there? Total n are there here. So we have written here n here. Okay, so integral B2 dot dl is equal to mu naught I into n, where n is the number of turns. Now, BDL cos 0, we know that the DL and B are tangential to each other, so the value of theta is 0 here. That's why I have written here mu naught I into n. B2 into what is that loop integrate? Integrate the length of the loop R2 here. We will get 2 pi R2 into mu naught I into n. And we write B2 is equal to mu naught I n upon 2 pi R2. That is the number of turns per unit length of the number of turns per unit length. Number of turns per unit length here. B dot dl is given by mu naught into I into n upon 2 pi R2 is nothing but small n. Number of turns per unit length, we get it here. So the answer is mu naught I into n. This is the same as that of solenoid. So B is equal to mu naught n into I. So if you take, once again you see the derivation each step here. The loop 1 and loop 3 carries no current, so the value of B is 0. Only the loop 2 is carrying current here, effect of current it is carrying here. So only you will integrate the loop 2 here, that is integral dl, that is 2 pi r2. 2 pi r2 is the perimeter of that loop here, that is why we are taking. But that loop, how many turns it consists of? That is small n, number of turns consisting per unit length of the toroid is called small n here. So that is why n by 2 pi r2 is small n here. So the answer is mu naught n into I, small n into I, where small n is the number of turns per unit length of the solenoid in the second loop. Loop mein how many turns are there? I told you, if you take the loop, there are the turns. So how many turns are there? That we are going to take. That is called. Okay. So n upon 2 pi r2 is nothing but small n. That is number of turns per unit length of the toroid. In this way we calculate the magnetic field due to a toroid here. Generally the solenoid we consider as an electromagnet. As long as the current is flowing through the solenoid, it will show the magnetic properties, and so it is called electromagnet. Okay, how to increase the magnetic field of either solenoid or toroid? Inside the coil, we have to insert an iron, soft iron, whose relative permeability is more. In this way, we can increase number of turns, we can increase, and the amount of current passing through the solenoid or toroid, we can increase. So, solenoid or toroid, what are the factors to increase the magnetic field? Number one, increase the strength of the current. Number two, increase the number of turns. And number three, insert in place of air any other material whose relative permeability is more. Example, soft iron. Then only it will produce maximum magnetic field. Okay, children. So these are the applications of Ampere's circuital law. 4 applications we have studied. Please practice it very well. Definitely one will come in your board examination. Okay, practice the derivations and stay safe, be happy. Okay, see you. Bye-bye.